This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA.
Welcome back to Corespun and the tutorial knot. In this technique, we are going to be doing similar to the study I have on my bobbin, where we're going to be making puffs. But after turning them into puffs, we're going to be tying them into knots. So my inspiration for this yarn is going to be sea anemones. We are going to be using an alpaca bamboo as our base. And then I'm going to use a bit of a feisty fen art bat for the puff, very similar to how I used the silk before. But I'm going to include some sparkle within the puff, kind of sticking out like a sea anemone. And then we're going to knot it to secure it. So let's get started. I'm just going to use the end of my yarn as a leader thread loop. We'll tie it in a knot here. I do a lot of my yarns back to back. Even when I'm not doing videos production wise, I like to fill the whole bobbin and then take my yarns off. I find that saves me time. Okay, let's start with some alpaca bamboo. I got this blend from Lush Fiber Company, one of the contributors for this series, and you can find her shop and all of the other contributors for this series on my fibers page on howtospinyarn.com. So we'll just spin a length of yarn. So if we end up knitting or crocheting this, we'll have a nice clean cast on or bind off. Not a requirement, but it's always nice. I like to kind of get into the rhythm. Okay. So let's see how to do these sea urchins. So we're going to make a puff on top of sparkle. So I think what I'll do is I'll pinch the sparkle at the top and then kind of sculpt fiber onto the bottom. Okay, so we have sparkle at the top. It's kind of a half and half puff. Half sparkle, half, you know what's gonna happen? We're gonna have to break this, but you know what? That's totally fine. Break your core thread, tie your sea urchin in a knot. Oh, I love it. I absolutely love it. Look at this. It's even better than I thought. It's totally a sea urchin. Look how cute that is, you guys. I absolutely love it. I adore this. It is so cute. If I'm in Japan, I think it's kawaii. Okay, so now take your core thread and hold on to it with your pinky, and we're going to core spin starting at the base of this yarn. And watch this. We're just going to core spin over the ends, locking them in. No one will ever know that we had to break our core in order to make these cute sea urchins. No one will know except you and I, because we have skills. Core spin over the base, making sure that the base is the core yarn, making sure that you've core spun over the two ends nice and tidy so that they're locked in. And let's make another sea urchin. We'll put some sparkle at the top and a white puff. Pinch it to the core and wrap and wrap and wrap. Wrap and wrap and wrap. Break the core. Tie the white part in a knot. Fluff out the sparkle. We've got another sea urchin. Now take our core yarns and hold the ends together. And holding the base nice and firm, we'll begin to corespun over the base of this sea urchin to lock it in. And then our two cores, since we had to break them, will naturally twist together. And there goes the end. And no one would know that there's ends here. Take care as you put your urchin onto your bobbin that your pegs or your hooks don't damage them. Let's make another one. Do some sparkle, and we'll get a little puff of art bat. And then we'll break our core, and I'm always holding tension right at the base of where I'm sculpting the sea urchin. I never let go of this. Tie it in a knot where the white is the knot and the sparkle puffs out. And two ends together. Twist nice and secure around the base, and then corespin the two ends together. Gently get it on the bobbin. We'll do some more yardage. I think I'll make two more of these. One of my favorite things as a fiber artist is things like this, where you just take something that you find cute and create it with fiber. Nice and tight at the base. And let's make sure we put our ends together so we don't lose them. This practice of spinning two ends together so that you don't see the break is really great technical practice. I've also done that if I've started spinning a yarn and my core starts to break, or I realize this core is rebelling against me, or this core just isn't right for this yarn, I'll go ahead and break the core and then start using another core. And then when I take the yarn off the bobbin, I'll either just cut the yardage from the first core, or sometimes I can't even feel the difference, especially if it was a fragile core and I realized, oh, this is just not holding up to what I'm putting it through, then I'll just break it and use something else. Last sea urchin or anemone. I don't know what I'm doing anymore. Creature. Last creature. And I'm breaking this with, I don't know, 7 inches, 8 inches of length. I don't want to break it too short, or else I feel like it won't be secure. And it's not necessary to break it out like super, super long either. That's really cute. I love it. It's so cute. So cute. You could also call them like upside down. Oop, look what happened. An opportunity for learning. I was holding my two ends together, but apparently I wasn't doing it well enough. So I'm just going to break the yarn, put the long core that's attached to the bobbin, pinch it with the yarn, and then just core spin over it. And we're back in business. Looks good. And what a cute technique. What other creatures or textures or things in nature can you make inspired by knots? I would love to see what you spin using this technique. As with all the corespun techniques, just tie it in a knot when you're done, leaving it under tension. Don't let go. And either let it sit on the bobbin for a week or steam it. But yeah, with all my corespun yarns, I don't let them just kind of fall apart. This one is rebellious though. Look at that. Stay. Cool. You don't want it to fall apart. So don't let it go loosey-goosey all over itself. Definitely keep it under tension until you're ready to use it. And you can do that by winding it on a ball or winding it on a skein winder or a nitty knotty and just being careful not to, how do I say, just let it go loose. Just keep it under tension when you wind it. Thank you for watching and happy spinning.